close my eyes and colors fly. There's no hiding from your grace. I can't deny your heart for mine in its unrelenting chase. I was on the edge of deception, caught up in my own hesitation, until your love took over me. So I let go and I let love show me life like it's supposed to be. An oasis here awaits us, all the freedom I'll ever need. Now I'm alive. Oh la la, oh la la. When I let go, then I find life. Oh la la, oh la la. When I let go, then I find life. La 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 la. When I let go, then I find life. The higher way is calling me to a life unlike before. The Father's heart is beckoning, and I can't resist no more. Lead me in the ways of devotion. I don't wanna get caught in the motions. My heart is only for you, Lord. So I let go and I let love show me life like it's supposed to be. An oasis here awaits us, all the freedom I'll ever need. Now I'm alive. Oh la la, oh la la. When I let go, then I find life. Oh la la, oh la la. When I let go, then I find life. La 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 la. When I let go, then I find life. So I let go and I let love show me life like it's supposed to be. An oasis here awaits us, all the freedom I'll ever need. Now I'm alive. When I let go, then I find life. La 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 la. When I let go, then I find life. Oh la la, oh la la. When I let go, then I find life. Oh la la, oh la la. When I let go, then I find life.
Hey friends, and welcome to One and All Kids.
We are in week two of our series called Think Tank, where we are putting our knowledge to the test.
We can always learn more about God, and today is no exception.
Our memory verse this month is from Proverbs 2, verse 6, and it says, "For the Lord gives wisdom. From his mouth comes knowledge and understanding."
Keep working on memorizing that verse so that we can remember that there's always more to learn about who God is and how much he loves us.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Last week, we learned about the wise men wanting to get more knowledge of Jesus. This week, we get to see what Jesus was like as a kid, just like you. Let's get into service.
To play another game here at One and All Kids. We
right
got
here.
Some Jenga.
Jenga.
Josh is here.
Josh.
Julianne is here.
Julianne.
Tyler's also here. Tyler,
hey.
What are we doing today?
All right. Today we are playing Speed Jenga. You have 1 minute. timers set on your phone. Now, you press the timer button to start your time, you take your move, then you press stop to make sure you have enough time left. You lose the game if you knock the tower over or if your timer runs out before the other person's.
That makes sense?
Whoever wins gets to pie the other person in the face with that Mount Everest of shaving cream pie.
There it is.
Wow, 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 wow.
All right, wow. You out in the audience, if you think Josh is gonna win, move to his side of the room. If you think Juliet is gonna win, move to her side of the room. And then cheer for them because they deserve it. All right, here we go.
I don't know if we deserve
Josh, you are gonna be taking the first move.
Okay, not ladies first, all right, cool.
No. We did ladies first before. Now we're doing Josh first because I just decided.
Better because your time goes out faster.
Maybe. Okay.
All right, here we go. Tell me when, Tyler.
3, 2, 1, Jenga.
Oh my goodness, what did you just do?
I don't know what I
you
did.
You have to put it back on top, Josh.
Ah! Give myself an extra second.
You have to put it back on top, Josh.
Put it back. Hey, you got it.
What? Oh! What does that mean? What does that mean?
It was between turns. Do we just restart?
It was between. Also, I heard some like clunk.
Yeah, let's restart it.
Ready? 3, 2, 1, go!
Okay. Wow. That was impressive. Okay.
Oh, you got a color going. This is a serious game.
Dead serious.
I'm Pastor Julianne, and we are here for the next week of our Think Tank series. We are continuing to grow in our knowledge of God this month, and I can't wait to learn with you. Last week, we learned about the wise men, their pursuit of knowledge, and their journey to worship Jesus. This week, we're learning about when Jesus was a kid, just like you. Our bottom line this week is knowing God is the most important thing. Knowing God is the most important thing. If we think that knowing God is the most important thing, then the Bible is the first place to go to learn. If we look specifically at the life of Jesus as he grew up and lived his life, we get to see how the Savior lived out his life so we can try to follow his example. When we read about God in the Bible, we're gaining knowledge about God. But does knowing about God mean the same as knowing God? Let's take a look at Luke 2:41-43. Says, every year, Jesus' parents went to Jerusalem for the festival of the Passover. When he was 12 years old, they went up to the festival according to the custom. After the festival was over, while his parents were returning home, the boy Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem, but they were unaware of it. Jesus was left behind in Jerusalem. Have you ever been lost in a store before? When his parents went to go look for him, where do you think he was? In Luke 2:45-49, we find out. It says, when they did not find him, they went back to Jerusalem to look for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple courts, sitting among the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. Everyone who heard him was amazed at his understanding and his answers. When his parents saw him, they were astonished. His mother said to him, "Son,
Why have you treated us like this? Your father and I have been anxiously searching for you. Why were you searching for me? He asked. Didn't you know I had to be in my father's house? Jesus was in the temple, learning from and teaching others. He was growing in his knowledge. The people were amazed at his understanding of the scriptures. They couldn't believe that a kid could understand about God as much as he did. For Jesus, even as a kid, knowing God was the most important thing. Jesus never stopped learning, and he was able to live out what he knew as he grew and did his ministry. The more time we spend learning about God from others and from the Bible, the more we get to know how we can be like him. I have someone here to talk about what this is like, so let's go hear from them.
Hey everybody, my name is Tyler, and I am here with a pretty cool science experiment for you guys today. Now, we've been talking about how knowing God is the most important thing. That means that it's a priority in our lives. We want to protect it from all the distractions and other things that we can choose to do or try to know about. So let's say that this paper is knowing God. This is the most important thing. We are going to protect it. I'm going to protect it by putting it in this beaker. This green water are the distractions that we can encounter in life. We want to protect our priority of knowing God because that is the most important thing. Now, I'm going to turn this upside down and I'm going to dunk it in the water. Our experiment today says that this paper should stay dry. It should stay protected against this green water, against the distractions of life, right? So here we go. We're going to try it. Dip it upside down. Put it in the water. Do you guys think it's dry? Do you think it's protected? I don't know. Let's find out. It's completely dry. It didn't get a single drop of green water on it. This is what our lives can look like when we make knowing God the most important thing. But let's try this again and see what happens if we let distractions get in the way of knowing God. We'll do our same experiment again, and we know that it's going to stay dry. But if we let distractions in by tilting our cup back and forth and letting all that green water get in, now our paper is all wet. We want to make sure that in our lives, knowing God is the most important thing. It stays dry and it stays distraction-free in our lives. Bye, guys.
Oh! Run and get it.
Oh, that was not good. I lost a lot of time on that one. All she's got to do is take her time. Wow.
Josh is at 30 seconds. He's still at 40. These are so wonky at the top.
They are wonky at the top.
I'm at 30 seconds.
Oh my goodness. Oh, okay, she's at 22, I'm at 17. Okay.
Is that the third completed row?
Oh!
Ladies and gentlemen, Julianne has won. And I will say that Julianne, regardless of if you knocked over the tower, you would have won anyways. Because Josh used two hands in his last pull of the Jenga block. He also used two hands in his retrieval of his fallen Jenga block, so he has violated the rules. But Julianne, congratulations. Everybody else, come back at the end of service to watch Josh get pied in the face with the pie that now includes $1,000 bill
and
a Jenga block.
I'll take it.
The $1,000 bill is fake.
No.
All right, see you at the end of service.
Knowing God is the most important thing. Like Jesus showed us, spending time with God is so important. We can read the Bible to learn more about people who have experienced God in the past, or we could pray. Learning how we can talk to God is an important part of our faith. We can also talk with other people who know God and learn from them. People like your family members, leaders, pastors, or friends. Take time to find trusted Jesus followers in your life and learn from them. You can get to know who God is through worshiping God with your life. We don't just worship by singing loud, we can worship God by living loud. As you live for God, you'll learn so many new things about God and even about yourself. This week, try to grow as much as you can in your knowledge of God by trying out a different way of learning about Him. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you so much for who you are and the fact that we get to know you. We get to know you just like a friend would. We pray that as we go into this week, you would show us new ways to learn more about you, maybe through talking to other people, maybe through reading the Bible, maybe by praying more. God, we pray that you would reveal yourself to us, that we would get to know you and get to just learn more ways and more reasons that we can love you. We pray all these things in your name. Amen.
Jesus was learning and teaching others when he was only 12. That's awesome.
I want to be able to teach and learn just like Jesus did.
Amen.
The good thing is that we can. Jesus learned from others who were older and wiser, and he also learned from the Bible. We can do the same.
I am so thankful that Jesus set a good example of what it means to learn from Scripture and from others.
Hallelujah.
I want to be so grateful for all the knowledge that God has given us to learn about Him too.
One way to keep thanking God for all He has given us is by giving our offering. When we give up something we love, like our money, for something we love more, like Jesus and the things that He is doing, then we are showing God and the world around us that Jesus is the most important thing.
Hallelujah!
You can talk to your parents and leaders about giving your offering today.
Next up is our chance to grow together. Whether you're going to community group or heading into worship, we are all excited that we get to do life together. Let's go.
There is a fire in my heart, to tell the world just who you are, in everything I do, in everything I say, I will never be ashamed, cause I just wanna let go, Jesus you have saved me so, I will never be ashamed, I will sing from the rooftops. With all that I have, I'm gonna lift up both of my hands, I'm gonna make it loud, gonna sing and shout from the rooftops. Oh, you are my God. Oh, you are my God. So with this fire in my heart, I'll tell the world just who you are, and everything I do, and everything I say, I will never be afraid, from the rooftops, with all that I have, I'm gonna lift up, both of my hands, I'm gonna make it loud, gonna sing and shout, from the rooftop, oh, oh. You'll never stop loving us, you'll never stop, no. You'll never stop loving us, you'll never stop, no. You'll never stop loving us, you'll never stop, no. You'll never stop loving us, you'll never stop, no. Rooftops, with all that I have, I'm gonna lift up both of my hands, I'm gonna make it loud, gonna sing and shout from the rooftops. Oh, you are my God,
you are my God.
You are my God,
you are my God,
you are my God,
you are my God.
are my God. You are my.
Helpless, you had won the victory. Before I fell into the darkness, you were out to set me free. Before I knew that I was broken, you poured out your grace on me.
Josh has collapsed the Jenga tower, and so now he is receiving this pie mountain in his face. Oh, here we go. Oh, the lunch lady's here. Look at this hairnet. Lovely. Awesome.
Ooh, oh, I actually hurt. I don't know how the ladies of the lunch do this, but they make it happen. No, I'm not ready, but for you.
Are you ready?
They're ready. Okay. Ready.
3, 2, 1. Oh, it's stuck. There it is. Thanks for being a good sport. We will see you next time at One and All Kids. Bye, everyone.
I love getting to learn and worship with all of you.
Next week is another chance for us to learn about God some more. So don't forget, bring some friends. Until then, we want to send you out into the week with one hope.
One life
in Christ. Bye.
Bye, friends.
Amen.